All right, everybody, we have arrived at the Speed Duel Showdown number 40 finals. K. Cole and Justice. Justice thinking he was going to get knocked out round one and be able to enjoy himself in his evening and watch the stream. Wrong. All the way to finals. And K. Cole, whose entry was paid by Odd Toxim, they matched up round one, and K. Cole destroyed the poor guy who paid his entry. It's also K. Cole's birthday, so wish him a happy birthday. We have, is this a Dragoon mirror? Let's go to main screen. Yep, we have a Dragoon mirror for finals, something we have not seen before. Also, first Speed Duel tournament ever. Wow, haven't played since 2011. Oh, you were in my neck of the woods in that era. That's kind of when I played before Speed Duel. That's an awesome start. Yeah, Dragoon is fun, huh? I was saying that, you know, in the showdown, we really didn't see Dragoon. I know it's a good deck. It's one of, like, the... It's definitely one of the best GX decks, specifically GX. It's one of, like, the top four or five decks right now. But we didn't really see it until, like, 3 weeks ago, and now here we are with a mirror in the finals. It'll be interesting to see. I haven't seen a mirror yet. Different, couple differences between these decks, these particular decks and these particular players. So K. Cole is using a Lure of Darkness. I think that K. Cole is using more Plasma and Dogma. Justice is using, I think, less Plasma and Dogma, no Lure of Darkness, less Dark Targets, kind of shied him away from a Lure of Darkness, but we have other good staples in there. So it'll be interesting to see how they counteract. K. Cole is getting Dragoon more frequently than Justice is in turn. Makes sense. So L set for K. Cole. Let's see. We start with the Breaker. Popping the Zoma. Good hit for Justice. And let's see what's behind this door. DD Warrior Lady. And, oh, nothing happens. Oh, we do banish, though. We are opting to banish, sure. I think both decks are running 3 DD Warrior Lady. I mean, it's the absolute counter to Dragoon. You gotta watch out for it. Dragoon can come back if it's in the grave, not in banish. End phase, Zoma for K. Cole. And now, look at the resource difference, you know? It's looking pretty good for Justice. But we'll see. We got a Zoma on the field. And we're looking for a Dragoon. There's the Allure. Oh, God. Please don't be blind. Now we're good. We got the Dogma. Gonna swing in for 18 with Zoma. See if that goes through. We got the Nightmare Wheel. Okay. Justice also playing Zoma Nightmare Wheels and Book of Moon secondary win condition. We've seen some burns in the bracket tonight. Just a set and pass. So are we bricking? But even if you get like two Dogma, you can still get Dangerous. Because Dangerous is just a Destiny hero and a Dark Monster. Another set and pass for K. Cole. Go back to Justice. Book of Moon on Zoma to reset it. Nightmare Wheel falling off that. Okay. Warrior Lady. Do we get this 15? It's going to bring K. Cole down to 2,000. It does go through. Justice looking pretty good now. Really good board. Cards in hand. And not even Dragoon can save K. Cole right now because Warrior Lady. We got to get rid of this Warrior Lady. Breaker, though. That Nightmare Wheel isn't attached to anything. That just hangs out. So we ate up a spell space for Justice already. Going to hit another Zoma. Pretty good hit. And yeah, we swing into this. Justice taking 100 and the Banish, but one back row left to potentially stop this. Zoma was a good hit, but it wasn't something that could have stopped this attack. Let's see if the other one is. Yeah, we're going to Banish. Good lord, another warrior lady. Bloodgated, though. Bloodgated, but still banish opportunity with something swinging into it. So still, Dragoon is not entirely safe. Pastor K. Cole, back to Justice, and this is the life of the game before Dragoon. Another Warrior Lady. Wow, so all three out on the board now. Battleface trying to slap for another 15. Yeah, I think those are both Zomas, and we gotta start using them. DD Warrior Lady can banish this Zoma. It might make more sense to keep the resource out and just take the 15. For Justice, but we'll see. Justice pretty high in life points still. Yeah. No effect banish. Looks like we're going to take it and keep rolling. Drops Justice down 24. Still ahead of K. Cole and just so ahead in resources right now. Looks good for him. Yeah, Breaker. Trying to dissect these DD Warrior Ladies with other monsters that aren't Dragoon. But Breaker going to take away the counter. And that's only 1,000 defense, so... I mean, DD Warrior Lady can get right over that. We are going to go for... Was that Plasma Dogma? Yeah. There's Dragoon. Oh, I see. We're going to try and do some burn here. So, Dragoon defense. Justice can remove this by slamming into it with Warrior Lady. Oh, we're going to destroy it and take the damage. No battle phase. That's right. That's right. Dragoon also has great effects. But then if, like, Justice gets Dragoon out, it's over. Yeah, this is where Justice needs Dragoon. All of these cards, but do you have it? Hard Book of Moon on Dragoon over here for K. Cole. Okay, Nightmare Wheel so he can't flip back up. And do we just go for the burn? Okay, that was all in the draw phase, so we can get the burn rolling. It's going to drop K. Cole down to 15, and another card set. But I think that in terms of attacking, we are out of options here. Zoma comes up. That's a DD Warrior Lady that's set on Justice's side. It was floodgated. So even if Zoma breaks through, Justice can certainly banish that. And it's all about strangling K'Kole for monster resources and getting the burn, I think. Yeah, Breaker was Book of Moon, not Floodgated. We can actually get this back. Not currently tethered to any Nightmare Wheel. Zoma can... I mean, we're going to get banished here, I think. But then we get a free swing. Well, potentially swing for game here with K'Kole. Zoma. Oh, no. And that's lethal for K'Kole if we swing into it also. Man, that's a tough spot. Zoma next turn can just knock down Breaker for 200. But do we even put it? Do we even need to put it into attack? Like, what else can they do? Yeah. Good first game for K'Kole right there. That's Zoma. Only one Dragoon coming out on K'Kole's side, and it was, that's definitely what turned the tides. Being able to get rid of that Warrior Lady and inflict damage to Justice right there. And putting up the wall. Side phase. Do we have defuse? That works pretty good here. All right, going to game two. Justice up a game. Meanwhile, do we have our bronze match going on? Bronze match was Tetra and Chinstrap. I think it was Chinstrap that recommended trying to hold bronze and then doing streaming finals and bronze. But one of the reasons why I shy away from that is, like, case in point, Tetra is it's like literally 3:30 in the morning for him, and I feel bad holding that for him. Sometimes we catch bronze and finals ends early, but it's not always the right play. Get out of here. Okay, Justice. Turn one. What do we got? Wow, a set. That's amazing. Get out, Creative Cloud. Oh, thank you, K'Kole. I was so ready for this one to be boring. Just like the last one was kind of boring leading up to some of the Dragoon stuff. I mean, it's all just Warrior Ladies and Nightmare Wheels. We have Dangerous out. So we're going to be able to put another guy. Oh, it was double plasma. Nice. Oh, hate to see it. Stop. We're going to be able to put something. We were going to be able to put something in the grave, do an extra six. Well, doesn't matter. It was in defense. Okay. There goes the Warrior Lady in. Oh, no. So the Warrior Lady swung in. So we still get this damage. You can discard a card. So we don't have a card to discard, so it's just 2,000. Okay, so K. Cole opening up strong here. Down a game, floodgate on this breaker. And now just two resources left here. Justice, normal summon the breaker. Going to be able to beat over that with Dangerous, no problem. We have two back row, we're going to pass. So K. Cole, a little risky, but potentially a good payoff. If we top deck a monster, we're looking pretty good. Got to watch out. Justice is going to have Floodgate, Nightmare Wheel, Zoma, Book. We got it all. I think Justice has Wall Disruption, but we might have sided it. Okay, that swing's going to go through. There goes the breaker. Imagine if Justice gets Dragoon. We just slap Destiny Hero Dangerous. Breaker with a counter, not quite going to get up to a Dangerous attack. And we can actually do the quick effect now. We're going to pop that last back row. It's going to be Chained Cosmic Cyclone, dropping K-Cole down to 29. And that hits the... Oh, Defusion. And that effectively wiped out all of K-Cole's resources except the card in hand. Now Justice can pretty comfortably use this breaker to start beating him down. There goes 16. All right, Blind Allure, maybe. No, we had the Dogma in hand, so we had a brick. But Allure, that's why Allure's good there. DD Warrior Lady. Nuh-uh. Bricks? No way. Dogma Plasma, you drew Dogma Plasma, no! And we already had Fusion Party. That's one of the downsides of this deck, unfortunately. Justice seriously won the Dragoon Mirror without ever playing Dragoon. He never fusion partied. Like, what do you take away from that? What do you even do with that? Like, K. Cole fusioned both games. Justice just won with Warrior Lady and Nightmare Wheel. Good lord. Way to go, Justice. I hope you're happy. We can actually catch the end of bronze here. So this is the bronze match for third place. We got Dr. Chinstrap and Tetra. Let's go over to them. We have Chinstrap was playing Guardians of the Tomb, hence all of the trap monsters. But it looks like we switched to Hidden Parasite with Bug Spray. And Tetra's also... What is Tetra playing? Dragoon? I don't think we've seen Tetra yet. What the heck is this? We have not seen Tetra on stream yet. What the heck is he playing? What are all these? Oh, we're just playing like straight up good like Destiny heroes here. We got the Jinzo there as a dasher. All right, send the graveyard. Draw monster during your draw phase. Reveal it. Special summon it. Is 2100 attack and get out potentially kind of like Cyber Dragon style. These swamp mirrors are 18. GX Monarchs maybe. There is Malicious and Hades here. It's going to be a difference of three. And this is game three. I still can't believe that Justice won the Dragoon Mirror without ever fusioning. He could have literally just been playing like Warrior Burn. He could have been digging for gold. He would have been better off with digging for gold. Okay. All right, yeah, so it changed the defense position, right? So swap mirror just over that, yeah. It's not great, but yeah, it's okay. It is a warrior. Yeah, I guess this is the malicious Monarch deck that I guess exists. Double set from Tetra here. Chinstrap. Bug Spray not going to help here. Got the Swamp Mirror out. It's a trap monster heavy deck. We'll see what else we can do there. Warrior Lady's going to get the Banish off. True. Why would my opponents take up card spots for Sighting and Defusion if I was running Digging for Gold? All right, that's true. You have to have the threat of Fusion out there. It's valuable in the way that it's not. Why get card draw when you can strike fear in the heart of your opponent? All right. We got the Dangerous and Jinzo. Okay. Tetra. Taking game three with... I don't even know what this is. I guess it's the Malicious Monarchs deck. Is that what we're calling it? Tetra taking third place. Okay. That was weird. What an interesting finals for sure. Oh, boy. All right. So that is your top three for Speed Duel Showdown number 40. With the GX Mirror, we have Justice 2-1 over K. Cole. K. Cole, happy birthday and fantastic work. We're going to pay out top three within the next day. So we'll see that. It's 55% to first, 30% to second, 15% to third. Tetra, you got third place. Congratulations. 2-1 over Chinstrap with whatever that is. Malicious Monarchs, Jinzos, and Dangerouses. There you have it. Cool. Thanks for another great showdown, everybody. You guys are fantastic. I don't think... we'll just cut it off. I don't have anybody to raid. Thank you guys again for all your support. And wrapped up in a tight hour and a half, as expected, which is great. So, thanks, everybody. Catch you guys next week. We'll talk soon.